Hello, Krill. Once again, I'm so happy that you're joining us live from Moscow. Thank you so much for joining us again on Head Start.
Thank you, Karen.
All right. A landmark event for Sputnik V. You are one of four vaccine brands that recently published your phase three clinical trial results at Lancet magazine. So this is a major step forward for Sputnik V.
Yes, definitely, Karen. So only four vaccines published their interim phase three results, and Sputnik V is one of those. And based on this result published in The Lancet, our efficacy is 91.6% for protecting against COVID and 100% for protecting of severe cases against COVID. And what this means is that there are only three vaccines in the world right now with efficacy more than 90% of protecting of COVID, and Sputnik V is among them. And this is a great accomplishment and another important worldwide recognition of the mankind vaccine that Sputnik V is, because it has great efficacy, it has great safety, it has great logistics, because it can store it at +2, +8 degrees centigrade regular temperature. And it also has a very good price of less than $10 per shot.
Yeah, and you are only one of three vaccines with a 90 plus efficacy that has published your phase three clinical trials. What parts of the world did you conduct the clinical trials?
So this is mostly based on Russian data, but we also had clinical trials in United Arab Emirates, in Belarus, in Venezuela, in India. So we have, you know, wide number of countries that really undertook exploration of Sputnik. And by now, what's very important, Sputnik is already registered by 16 countries. And this week, actually 12 countries will start vaccinating with Sputnik, and 12 new countries. And out of those 12 countries, for 10, this is the first ever vaccination of their population. So Sputnik V is already very much recognized, not only by the Lancet and scientific community, but actually by regulators of 16 countries who registered Sputnik V so far.
All right. Before we go, I go to the bigger picture of Sputnik. I want to ask you, because the last time I interviewed you, you did say that Gamaleya was going to conduct clinical trials in the Philippines, that the Philippines was supposed to be part of the phase three clinical trials of Sputnik V. But that didn't push through. What happened?
Yeah, I think it was just, you know, taking some time. And what we realized is that already data we have in Russia is sufficient for most regulators worldwide. So we have Sputnik register in Africa, in Algeria, in Middle East, in UAE, in Europe and Hungary, you know, in Argentina and Bolivia and Latin America. So we already are recognized as a vaccine that is effective and that is safe. And frankly, we believe Sputnik is the best vaccine in the world. So right now we're in close discussions with Philippines to actually provide Sputnik V vaccine to Philippines, but without new clinical trials, because clinical trials we've had already proved very high safety and very high efficacy of Sputnik V vaccine.
Okay, the efficacy that came out in the clinical trial, to be exact, Kirill, is 91% or
93.6%.
91.6.
Over 60 years old, it's actually slightly higher. It's 91.8%. And what's also important, 100% protection against severe cases of COVID, and also no allergies, no anaphylactic shock that we see in some other vaccines, and very good safety profile. So 94% of all of the you know, side effects were really minor, and there were no side effects related to the vaccine. So basically we are you know, one of the top vaccines in the world, and we're excited to work with Philippines. We believe that we can protect not only Russian people, but also Philippines people as well.
All right. I want to ask you specifically, because there are different types of vaccines and they're manufactured differently. Gamaleya, Sputnik V is a viral vector vaccine, right? In effect. And you are similar to AstraZeneca, Janssen, and CanSino Biologics. Are you familiar with that?
Yes, of course.
In terms of the manner, well, in terms of the method and the manner. And I wanted to ask you, because one disadvantage, some say, is that it's relatively complex to manufacture.
Yes, so basically we are this human adenoviral vector, and we chose this technology because it's the safest technology. Mm-mm. It has been tested for decades, unlike mRNA technologies that is very new and has really not been tested for a long time. And we have a combination of big safety and also high efficacy. And for example, we work with AstraZeneca to increase the efficacy of their vaccine by adding one more component of Sputnik. But it is true that production, you know, is taking some time to ramp up. And also lots of production is now going to Russia, because we want to make sure Russian people are protected. And we have mass vaccinations that will be completed by June in Russia.
Okay.
So when we talk about international markets, we can start supplying some vaccine in February, some in March, but really big volume starting from May of this year already, given some of the existing contracts we have.
Okay. So I know that you applied for an emergency use authorization in the Philippines. And what is the status with that, Krill?
So we are working very close with your regulator. You have a very diligent and very professional regulator. We have sent them all of the information, and that information was enough to approve Sputnik in 16 countries. And by the way, we expect, you know, another 8 or 10 approvals of Sputnik in the next couple of weeks. So we'll have lots of countries approving it. So we hope to really get approval in Philippines soon. And we believe this cooperation with Philippines is very important. Because we want Russian people to be protected and people in other countries as well.
I'm curious, are you also applying to be part of the WHO COVAX facility vaccine? Because the Philippines, I think, will be having that as the first vaccines coming into the country officially through the COVAX facility. Are you applying for that too? Are you joining that?
Yes, we are submitting documents for COVAX, and WHO is going through the process of registration. But also lots of the supplies we have will be directly to countries. Mm. Because frankly, COVAX has been very slow to deploy vaccines around the world.
Yeah.
COVAX has been really very slow to give vaccines to any country. Mm. So we cannot wait for that. We will be supplying vaccines to countries directly. And as I mentioned, 12 countries will start vaccination with Sputnik this week.
Okay, so 12 countries
really
this week. All right,
yes.
Let's get to the numbers. How many in Russia have you already inoculated using Sputnik V? I'm presuming, is Sputnik V the only vaccine brand that's accessible in Russia now?
Well, we actually have three different vaccines, and Sputnik V was was the first one, and we have two other vaccines that also another one is available, and a third one will be available soon. Mm. And already more than 4 million vaccines have been distributed throughout Russia. Mm. Now, some of them have already been injected, you know, others are being injected right now, but we are talking about millions of vaccines that have been distributed across Russia. Mm. And we expect that we will have all of the people who want to be vaccinated in Russia to be vaccinated by June of this year. And following May and June, we can really have very massive rollout of our vaccines throughout the world as well.
Yeah. How many are you targeting to inoculate in Russia by the end of the year?
So again, not by the end of the year, but by June, we believe that we'll inoculate around 60 million people. And we believe that we can provide our vaccine to more than 500 million people worldwide this year. And we believe that it's very important that people understand the efficacy of the vaccine, because you have efficacy of the vaccine more than 90%. Why would you use a vaccine with efficacy much lower than that?
Yeah.
And I think we really are focused on providing vaccine with efficacy more than 90% that can be stored at +2, +8 degrees centigrade at a good price point to the world. And we really call Sputnik V the humankind vaccine, because we focused on safety, efficacy, price, and logistics.
Yeah. And Krill, Sputnik V also requires 2 shots.
Yes, and we are very unique in this, because we use 2 different shots of our vaccine. And when you use 2 different shots, basically it is a much more efficient way. And this is why, for example, we offered one of our shots to vaccines that have efficacy of 60-70%, because if they add one of our shots to their shot, the efficacy will also increase. Mm-hmm. So two different shots is some of the power behind the efficiency of Sputnik V vaccine.
Okay. Have you already delivered vaccines to any other country?
Yes, of course, Karen. So already 16 countries are vaccinating their people with Sputnik right now. And this week, as I mentioned, this is 12 new countries that have started, out of which for 10 countries, this is the first vaccine ever. And it's Argentina, it's UAE, it's Hungary, it's Serbia, it's Algeria, it's Palestine, it's, you know, lots of countries around the world.
Yeah. All right. And in the Philippines, I know that you're closely speaking with, I'm presuming, our vaccine czar, and also the team that's in charge of purchasing vaccines. Where are we with that? I mean, have they actually made an order for Gamaleya?
Yeah, we are basically in process of discussions. We are waiting for registration. I think it's also clear that we can only be one of the vaccines in Philippines. And I think Philippines is doing a very wise approach to have different vaccines from different countries to reduce supply risks, to reduce technology risks. So basically, we'll be waiting for their approach. Right now, frankly, we have much more demand for our vaccines that we can supply. But we believe Philippines is a great priority for us, and we've been working with your team for quite some time. So we are looking forward to finalization of the registration of the vaccine in Philippines and to then start supplying it to the Philippines market.
Yeah. And I'm curious, are they negotiating for a type of grant, for example, when it comes to Sputnik V vaccines?
What do you mean, supply grant?
Like, are they negotiating, let's say, for a grant or a special arrangement?
No, for us, it's very straightforward. So our vaccine is one of the most affordable in the world. Mm. It costs less than $10 per shot. Mm. And basically, it's half or one third of the price of mRNA vaccine. So it's a very affordable vaccine. And we have the same price for all of the countries. And this is why we call Sputnik humankind vaccine, because not only is it safe, efficient, but it's also very affordable. Mm-hmm. And when we focused on what vaccine to back, affordability was one of the core areas of focus, because we wanted also, for example, to make sure we don't need to store vaccine at minus 70 degrees centigrade, yeah, because this requires huge investment in infrastructure. So yeah, it's easy to deliver, it's very affordable, it's safe, and it's efficient.
Okay, has the first family, as Vladimir Putin also, has he already been inoculated?
Well, he mentioned that part of his family was inoculated. He still didn't announce his own inoculation. But we have President of Argentina who's been inoculated, President of Guinea who's been inoculated, and pretty much lots of key people in Russia have been inoculated, including our mayor of Moscow, our minister of defense, our minister of industry. So lots of key people in Russia have been inoculated. And of course, we know the vaccine is safe, and this is also recognized now by The Lancet, which is one of the most respectable magazine in the world.
Yeah, because Sputnik V is a viral vector vaccine, so to speak. There's a group of doctors in the Philippines. Let me read this. Well, it's the Philippine Society of Allergy, Asthma and Immunology. They came out essentially just with a comparison among all the vaccines. And they say that people who have been previously exposed to the human virus used as a vector may have weaker immune response to this type of vaccine due to previous immunity to the vector. What exactly, in layman's terms, would that mean? And do you see that as accurate?
No, this is exactly that our scientists solve this problem. So the problem was, if you use human virus, which is very safe, which we use, and some people have had been sick with it before, does vaccine not work? But we showed that it works 100% to protect against COVID, and efficacy is 91.6%. Mm. So we've proven this viewpoint wrong by data.
Okay.
In the Lancet article.
Yeah.
And this is exactly why, and how our scientists did it. We used two different vectors, adenovirus 26, adenovirus 5. So basically, we were able to prove that our approach works. And this really answers all of the questions, because everybody recognizes it's one of the safest approaches out there. Okay. Now the question was, would it be efficient? And the answer in The Lancet, it's one of the three most efficient vaccines in the world, with efficacy more than 90%.
Now, there's been some feedback, for example, with the Moderna vaccine, that the second shot has caused fever, chills, high-grade fever, chills, some were nauseous, vomiting, and no less than Dr. Fauci even said that he experienced it. And there's a warning that it could stay with you for 3 days. Is there any effect with the second shot of Sputnik V?
Well, as I said, 94% of all of the effects from the vaccine are very, mild. Light and mild. And basically, where we are is that one of the benefits of our vaccine, it uses a human adenoviral vector, so it's just a light flu. And it's modified, so it cannot replicate. So yes, some people feel half a day, maybe a day, they feel a little bit under the weather, but this is because there is a reaction of immune system. But it's not strong response at all. And frankly, it happens not in a large number of people, in less than 10% of people. So this is again why we chose our human adenoviral platform, because it creates, you know, doesn't create strong allergies, doesn't create a selective shock, because we all had some flu virus before, we all, you know, are doing well with it, and this is the core of our vaccine.
All right. Anything you'd like to add before we go, Krill?
No, thank you, Karen. I think it's just very important that Sputnik is recognized internationally. Last time we spoke, there were lots of questions, but now 16 countries have registered Sputnik, Lancet published phase three. So really, all of the questions have been answered, and we have been working very hard to make Sputnik available to different people in different countries, of course, including the Philippines.
Yeah. And how many have you already distributed worldwide to the 16 countries? How many have you distributed, and how many are you targeting to produce, like every month, for example? Because we know that vaccine companies aren't able to keep up with the orders and the demand.
Yes, we basically like to stick to the number I mentioned, which is, you know, this year we'll deliver more than 500 million doses. We don't disclose exactly how much we're delivering right now, and the big focus is on vaccination in Russia. So we basically can deliver, you know, 5% of people's, of countries' order, you know, 5%. This month, 5% next month, and then the rest we deliver over the next 6 months. And this is how we approach our agreement, to make sure we can start vaccination, but then we deliver most of the vaccines for countries that haven't ordered before, starting from May.
Yeah. All right. No idea yet how many the Philippines would want to order from Gamaleya?
No, let's wait for your government's decision, and we are working very closely with them.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us once again. Krill Dimitriev, the CEO of a Russian investment fund, live from Moscow. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Karen.